Research, the application of the science, the economic research, and the application of the science, the social research. been tracking a lot of Prakhar's work, you find that most of what he's been doing recently has been around socionomics, which is more the social research rather than even directly the economic cycle. This very book covers the quantitative cycle in brief, and it covers psychology of investing, which once you understand, you can actually put two and two together even in fundamental research. So, since based on where we actually lie in the economic cycle, it's an important juncture where I thought that the economic part was really important for people to understand and to give a perspective. Because even while I wrote, I've been writing on my blog, which is indiacharts.com, a lot on the cycle. I haven't really covered the economic data. So today, some of the data which I'm going to provide and then show you how it has happened in other markets, it will give you a clear perspective of how the cycle works and where we are placed in India within that cycle. Okay, so that's what we're going to do, and if there's time, we'll look at more charts. Just a brief on R&D. As far as I can remember, he was an accountant. He fell ill and moved from Mexico to California. And during his illness, he looked at a lot of data which he managed to get, a lot of historical data. And he discovered that there was a pattern to price behavior. And that pattern has come to be known as the Elliott wave form or the Elliott wave fractal. He wrote a piece of work after meeting Charles Collins. Charles Collins actually came across him somewhere in the mid-30s, 1934-35. He came across his work, and he asked him to write for the Financial World magazine, which Collins was covering. And through those articles, a lot of his work got to actually reach people. And eventually, he wrote the Elliott Wave Principles original work, and later on Nature's Law, which covered the principles action in real life. His work was really bought into the Financial World by Hamilton Bolton, who later on wrote several reports, financial reports in the financial business with institutional investors, and thus people came to more widely know about the Elliott Wave principle. A.J. Frost later on took on from Bolton, and Robert Prechter, whose book I just showed you, The Elliott Wave Principle, was then written by the two of them, A.J. Frost and Prechter, together, and that book has become the Bible, the textbook for anyone who wants to actually learn and practice Elliott Wave theory. Of course, there have been further iterations to the theory by Glenn Neely, by some recently wrote about harmonic waves and so on. But what I stick with is the evolutionary theory, which Prechter has written about. These 200 pages in this book are everything. I mean, when we practice, when I teach the people who actually work with me, if you don't agree on something, it's the book. You just throw the book at somebody, and not literally, but if you know what I mean. And the answers are all there. You probably would refer to it again and again once you understand. So when people expect that there's something more to it, you're missing something, there's not something more to it. Everything is in there. You just don't get it. Either because you've not been practicing for a long enough period of time, so you can't see it in prices yet. But I myself got to using the wave principle only sometime in 99. I started looking at it. I started doing technicals from 92. So for several years, I was using only trend following. I believed that there was no way you could forecast markets if the trend goes up. It stayed up. As long as it stayed up, that's the classical thinking. It's only because when you start believing, so as long as you're a non-believer, you never believe in something. So this doesn't work. So this is all rubbish. The way that it worked for me is that by force, because of something that that happened, I decided that no matter what, I should know about the Elliott Wave principle. I just opened far superior, far greater than you can actually imagine when you can actually put it. That's the difference it made. And it was only possible because I decided to apply it blindly. I did not think whether it would work or it would not work. I just started applying it and the results were for me to see. So you have to believe, that's the first step. Okay. Why does the fractal work? The fractal works because in a sense, price behavior of markets is an actual reflection of mass behavior. Okay. When we are looking, and especially when we are studying a large cap index like a Sensex, a Nifty, a Dow, it actually reflects market cap of the biggest company, which means the human behavior of a very large mass of people put together. Through a lot of work, Prechter is actually, he's discussed the basic problem in our thinking that we always think cause and effect. This is the cause, that is why the markets went up. This is the markets are an effect of something that happened, some bad news that came out yesterday. What has actually come out of this entire study is that the markets are the cause, reflect the cause, okay? And what you read about and what is happening around you in terms of events are actually the effect of that. So, why is this so? It's because humans tend to hurt. That's how, and it's not just human, all living beings, if you see how animals behave, they all tend to hurt. And this hurting behavior builds over a period of time. We follow leaders, and once we find leaders, there's greater following. If it's if he's a hero, then he has wide following. And as that following builds up, that behavior, the behavioral pattern of following something shows up in the aggregate waveform, because it's basically a reflection of mass human psychology. Another way to put it is that if you had two stadiums, which were full jam-packed, and something happened, say a bomb exploded in both of them, the behavior that you would see, the reaction of people, is always the same to the same environment, which is why behavior is repetitive, especially when it has a mass. You might not behave individually the same. I may behave differently to that event, you might behave differently to that event, but as a crowd, we tend to behave in the same way. So what is this fractal? So we'll just discuss what this fractal looks like. I've shown it on this chart. Essentially, the fractal breaks up into 5 waves in one direction and 3 waves in the opposite direction. Okay, which means that if I say the broader trend is up, things are going to move positively, then the fractal breaks up into 5 waves, which we mark as 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay, and the fractal against the broader trend breaks up into an ABC. Okay. The same is also true if the broader trend is down. Okay, if it is down, then the fractal breaks up into 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 down and ABC upwards. This is the basic fractal of behavior. This behavioral fractal, okay, a lot of people, I hope everyone understands when I say fractal. What is a fractal? Does everyone understand what is a fractal? How many people don't understand what is a fractal? So I'm using that word again and again. A lot of people don't understand. I have to create forms which were difficult to actually create you know, directly, like clouds, you know, such a difficult form. So computers, when they were not as powerful as they are today, a lot of software programming was done creatively and not by writing extensive pieces of code the way Microsoft does. And this was one way in which animation tried to simplify its work, which is the use of fractals. So that's how I came across it. So when I say fractal, I'm simply saying that this 5-3 form, this is a fixed pattern, it's a fractal, okay, and it repeats. So I'll show you how it repeats. So this pattern of behavior repeats at every degree. You know, so when I say every degree, whether I'm looking at an hourly chart, whether I'm looking at a daily chart, whether I'm looking at a monthly, quarterly, yearly, any kind of data, any kind of time frame, okay, the fractal continues to repeat itself.